graph of the function f of x equal to sin inverse x. We have already discussed inverse function in function chapter. So what I'm going to tell is, when we are drawing the graph of the function f of x equal to sin inverse x, we must have to know the graph of the function f of x equal to sin x. So here f of x equal to sin x, graph of f of x equal to sin x is given. Already we have discussed the graph of f of x equal to sin x in 11th class. So we have to redefine the function f of x equal to sin x for which the function f x will be bijective. That means function will be 1, 1 and round 2. So let's take a portion from the total graph for which the function f of x equal to sin x will be 1, 1 and round 2. So here I am taking a portion. And this is the redefined portion for which the function f x will be bijective. After that, we will draw the graph f of x equal to sin inverse x. So very important part is, if this is the graph of the function f of x equal to sin x for which the function f of x is bijective, then we must have to draw a line y is equal to sin x for which suppose we are taking the mirror image of this portion, mirror image of f of x equal to sin x with respect to y is equal to x, we are getting the complete graph, which will be graph of the function f of x equal to sin inverse x. Here this point is given, pi by 2 comma 1, and here another point is also given from starting portion, that is equal to minus pi by 2 comma minus 1. So many points are there in between minus pi by 2 to plus pi by 2. So our target is, we are taking mirror image of all points or mirror image of the curve with respect to the line y is equal to x. Suppose this is a portion and this is a portion. Let's consider right portion starts from origin with respect to the value x equal to pi by 2, and we are taking the mirror image of this graph. When we are taking mirror image of this graph, so with respect to the line y equal to x, so required graph will like this. Required graph will like this. Same thing also happen in case of left side. Suppose we are taking the mirror image of this portion with respect to the line y is equal to x, portion of the graph is like this. Portion of the graph is like this. Similarly, here point is pi by 2 comma 1. Suppose I am taking mirror image of pi by 2 comma 1, I will get the point 1 comma pi by 2. Here also I am getting the point mirror image of minus pi by 2 comma minus 1. I am also getting a point which is equal to minus 1 comma minus pi by 2. So finally, the graph of f of x equal to sin inverse will be like this. Finally, the graph of the function f of x equal to sin inverse will be like this, and this point is 1 comma pi by 2, and this point is minus 1 comma minus pi by 2. This is the function graph function f of x equal to sin inverse x. Let's take an activity. Here suppose I am taking, suppose here this is the coordinate axis is given. Suppose I am taking, this is a graph of sin x. Let's consider, I am taking graph of sin x. So if this is the graph of f of x equal to sin x, when I am going to calculate graph of f of x equal to sin inverse x, so definitely I have to take mirror image of this portion with respect to the line y equal to x, where the graph will just reverse part like this. Just reverse part, which will be the graph of the function f of x equal to sin inverse x. So let's discuss it again. Suppose this is the curve f of x equal to sin x. When we are taking the mirror image of this curve with respect to y is equal to x, we are getting the portion like this. We are getting a portion like this, which will be mirror image of the function f of x equal to sin x, and which will be graph of the function f of x equal to sin inverse x.